Ray. What do you want to do tonight?
The same thing we do every night, Pinky. Try to take over the world.
They have lied to us. There is no lack anywhere in the universe. There is always, and I mean always, more than enough for all of us. We live in an infinite, abundant, replenishing universe. There is never any lack anywhere. There is more than enough food, money, opportunities, and resources. Even renewable resources. If one resource is running low, there is always an alternative that works just as good or even better. For example, oil. They want us to believe that we are dependent upon oil, that our engines, motors, and generators cannot function without it. This is all wrong. Do you know why? Because we have water. Yes, water. In the early 1990s, an inventor by the name of Stanley Myers created a water fuel cell that successfully converted water into fuel by splitting the hydrogen from the oxygen. It was so successful that it got over 100 miles per gallon. Myers' device could use either salt or fresh water. When news caught wind of Myers' invention, he was later poisoned to keep his product from being mass produced, and his invention was sold in an auction and mysteriously disappeared. What about energy? Are we reliant only on oil for our energy source? No. In the 1920s, Nikola Tesla started creating a device that tapped into the earth that would produce free energy for the world. But this device was later shut down and destroyed from lack of funding. Or what about Dr. T. Henry Moray, who created the first zero-point energy device? Yes, a device that could pull endless amounts of free energy from the ether. A 60-pound device that could power an entire house using no gas or battery. His device drew energy directly from the metafrequency oscillation waves. Despite over a dozen of successful demonstrations, investors refused to fund Moray's device for mass production. And after a break-in, his device and papers were destroyed. What about land? Is there a problem with overpopulation? Are we running out of space? Absolutely not. Mathematicians have now confirmed that the entire human race, yes, 7 billion people, could all live comfortably in the state of Texas. Last but not least, food. Is there a shortage on food in the world? Absolutely not. Studies show that developed countries waste enough food in one day to feed all 870 million starving people of the world. So the question is, why have they lied to us? It's because they want you to be scared. They want you scared. They want you uncertain and always in a state of panic and anxiety. See, when people are scared, they are predictable and easily controlled. When fear sets in, certain parts of the brain shuts down, and common sense and reason gets thrown out the window. Fear keeps people dependent. They want you to be scared, little sheep. But I'm here to remind you, of who you really are. I'm here to remind you of your infinite nature. You are a piece of God, having a human experience. Your true nature knows no lack. It only knows abundance. Nature is a perfect example of that. When things grow in nature, they grow in abundance. I recently had the pleasure of looking at an orange tree and was blown away by the amount of oranges I saw. There were so many oranges that I couldn't count them all. On top of that, there was hundreds of fallen oranges on the ground, rotting away. That showed me something. It showed me that not only is there more than enough, but there's also plenty to discard. We live in plentitude, and if we train our minds to focus solely on that fact, that would become our dominant experience. Poverty is a mental disease. It robs you of freedom and experience. It is the number one cause of stress, divorce, and criminal activity in the world. The only way to cure this mental disease is through changing your habitual thinking. See, our thoughts are dynamic in nature. They are very real things. If you don't believe me, look at the device you're holding in your hand. Yes, your cell phone. It was once an idea in someone's mind, and now it's a physical reality. In fact, anything that is not green or water was created and manifested by the human imagination. What you think affects what you believe, and what you believe becomes your reality. The simple truth is, if you believe you are poor, you will always remain in a state of poverty. You will never rise above your thinking. How can you? There can be no other way. There is a universal law that has no choice but to give us more examples of the things we believe. It is impartial and unemotional. As Stuart Wilde once said, it will give you diamonds or rocks depending on what you put out. So you must put out the belief that there is always more than enough. Speak abundance. Think abundance. Visualize abundance. Drum into your subconscious mind abundance. You cannot let lack back into your conscious mind. Abundance must be your only option. And before long, you will begin to develop new neural pathways that matches your new belief of abundance. Thus, you will begin to attract more abundance into your life. This advice might seem too simple to be valuable or true, but remember, simplicity is a sign of genius. This is Justin from You Are Creators, and if you enjoy this, you can purchase my best-selling books on Amazon. Just follow the link below in the description. Also, if you haven't already, you can download my wonderful app, The Law of Attraction Library. We have over 30 free books and 9 audiobooks for your listening and reading pleasure. Please leave a positive review. It will be greatly appreciated. This is Justin from You Are Creators, and we support your dreams.